Women's rights.
Women's rights.
Yeah. Bitch. Shout out to Hogan City, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I put it to. Shout out my. That's me. I'm in this TB. I'm in this full train. I just pulled on me a A. Run all in my face. 500 racks in my safe. 500 racks to the plug. What you know about showing love? What you know about pulling up? And barely trust. Make fall in love.
Women. The creator of all the good things in our planet had been discriminated a lot throughout the time. But it all started to change on April 7, 1848, when women finally gained their first civil right. The Married Women Property Act. This act allowed married women to own and sell real and personal property, control their earnings, and to sue and make wills. Without women, there will be no men.
After the Married Women Property Act was passed, it only took 2.5 months before people started standing up. This led to the Seneca Falls Convention that took place on July 19th to 20th that same year. This was the first convention that advertised women's rights, and is where they also signed the Declaration of Sentiments. Here's a reenactment of what it would have been like to attend the convention.
Y'all gotta sign this, bruh. Y'all gotta sign this.
Later, on May 15th, 1869, the National Women's Suffrage Association was created, which was made to fight for more amendments that supported women and their rights.
Damn, girl, what's your number?
Hey! That violates her First Amendment rights.
Yeah.
And I'm actually with the Women's Suffrage Association.
She's a woman. She doesn't have rights.
Actually, you're wrong about that.
It wasn't too long till other states took action, as on December 10th of the same year, Wyoming was the first state to allow women to vote.
Governor of Wyoming, sir, we're not gonna win the re-election. No men want to vote for us.
Really? I think I know someone that might.
They gonna love this one.
Finally, on August 18th, 1920, the 19th Amendment was passed, which gave women the right to vote.
My father would disown me for this one, but it has to be done.
There was then a lot of other small advantages given to women, like the approval of the first birth control pill on May 9th, 1960.
Birth control, free samples, $2 a pop, $2.
Sir, there's already medications for that.
No, you dummy. It means no more babies. Here, take a sample. There is a couple of side effects if you want to hear them, though.
No, it's okay.
But none more bigger than the Equal Pay Act passed on June 10th, 1963, which gave women the right to receive the same pay as men.
The Equal Pay Act didn't end the discrimination in the workplace, though. But that all changed when it was prohibited on July 2nd, 1964.
All right, can I get a name?
My name is Bill Lewis IV.
And what's your highest level of education?
Education? 6th grade.
Highest?
Yeah, that was my prime, man. That was my peak. I dropped out after that, but man, y'all reminiscing now. Come on, put it there.
All right. That's all we need to hear. Thanks.
It was a pretty big accomplishment.
That's all we need to hear.
Name, please?
Joe Johnson.
What's your highest level of education?
Yeah, as I said before many times, Harvard, master's degree. I went back on my doctor's degree. I was part of the U.S. Military, Marine, Navy SEAL as well. I was a nom.
All right, that's all we need. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
All right, Bill. So, I regret to inform you about this, but you didn't get the job, bud.
Excuse me? That's not how it's supposed to work. Give it to Jill. To Jill?
And then, only 5 years later, on September 5th, 1969, the no-fault divorce law was passed. This made it so that both the husband and the wife have to have consent to file for the divorce.
Lastly, there was the Roe v. Wade court case that was decided on January 22nd, 1973, which the Supreme Court recognized that the right to liberty in the Constitution, which protects personal privacy, includes the right to decide whether to continue a pregnancy.
Upon further investigation, this court has decided in favor of Jane Roe.
Come on now.
In conclusion to this documentary, we decided to go ask around in an everyday classroom to see how people currently feel about the current issues facing them.
Cry about it tomorrow.
Who am I here with today?
Hey, what are you doing? No, Melissa.
It's good.
Melissa Diaz.
What do you think are the issues that women face in today's society?
Definitely by the way we dress. If we like don't cover up, I guess it's like we're trying to get attention from guys and stuff. And I think it's also when we speak about like doing masculine things, like going to the gym or like doing things on our own, we like get like looked down like, oh, you can't do that because you're a girl and stuff.
Hello. Who am I here with in this evening?
Chris,
so today it's a serious topic actually. What are some of the associations that are fighting against the discrimination of women today?
What are some associations? I'm not sure.
You're not sure? Like organizations, anything?
No. Can you tell me some associations associated with women discrimination?
Sure thing. So we got the WNBA. We also got WNBA, yeah.
Equal
Pay Act or Black History Month?
Whoa. You gotta pick one.
Wait, what?
Question.
So does that mean like everyone gets paid like the same, like?
Yes, that's the equal. That's the Equal Pay Act.
No.
Yes.
She said
no. So she's against women.
No.
She's against women! What?